민교 왕기 여섯시 마도 텐디네 주변 똥은 되라 수동만이 생인다 수기동만이
So we read that the form is empty, emptiness is form, emptiness is not other than form, and form is also not other than emptiness. So this first expression, form is emptiness, refers to the manner in which form is said to be empty. For example, in Lanka Avatara Sutra, we find seven different ways of being empty, which are listed there. For example, one manner in which we can say something is empty of something, for example, say a temple is empty of monks. There's one way of being empty of, but here the emptiness, the temple being empty of monks is said to be an emptiness of the other, because one, the basis of emptiness is being empty of something else, whereas the when you say form is empty, the manner in which we understand something being empty of here is known as the emptiness of intrinsic nature, or rangtong. So when we speak of self-emptiness or emptiness of self-nature, we should not understand this to suggest that form is devoid of form. This is not understanding. Form is form, and that reality of form being form is not being rejected. What is being rejected here is that the form is devoid of intrinsic existence. So, for example, when we perceive form, we perceive it as if the form itself constitutes its ultimate reality. And however, if the form that we perceive itself constitutes its ultimate reality, then when we subject the form to a critical analysis seeking its true reality or ultimate reality, then form should be able to withstand that analysis. This is, however, not the case. When we subject the concept of form to critical analysis, it turns out to be unfindable through such analytic process. Therefore, what is being suggested here is that form is devoid of the existence in which we perceive form to be the case. Form do not exist in its own right as possessing some kind of intrinsic, independent reality. And this emptiness of form as possessing intrinsic reality is the ultimate nature of form. And this is the meaning of the first expression, form is empty. The second expression, emptiness is form. The meaning of this is that what is being suggested in this passage, in this expression, emptiness is form, is that because, as explained before, emptiness does not imply non-existence, emptiness implies the emptiness of intrinsic existence. So what this suggests is that the reality of things and events is their dependent origination. And because of that, their nature is dependent, therefore the fact that things can come into being as a result of causes and conditions, this law of causality becomes tenable. And so in the world of dependent origination, one can posit cause and effects, and this the world of cause and effects is possible only in a world that is dependently originated, and dependent origination is possible only if the world is devoid of intrinsic existence. Therefore, we can say that emptiness is form. This expression can be read as implying that form arises from emptiness. Emptiness becomes a basis which allows for the origination of form. So one can say that, in this sense, one can say that the world, the diverse world of forms, is an expression of emptiness, manifestation of emptiness. However, when we read this passage, that emptiness is form, form is emptiness, form is empty, and emptiness is form, particularly the second passage. And we spoke about how, in some sense, emptiness can be seen as the basis from which the form originates or evolves. Here it is important not to misunderstand this by thinking it to be sort of similar to a kind of a more absolutist concept, such as the concept of Brahman, which is seen as the underlying sort of reality from which the world of multiplicity comes out as a kind of an effulgence or as an expression. This is not the meaning here. Here, when we speak about emptiness, we are not talking about some kind of a core reality which lies at the heart of the universe, out of which comes out these diversity of phenomena. Because from the Madhyamaka point of view, emptiness is defined or described as a transcendence of conceptual elaborations, or freedom from conceptual of elaboration, or absence of conceptual elaboration. And this absence of conceptual elaboration can only be understood, can be understood primarily in terms of being transcending the conceptual elaborations, but not in terms of there being emptiness that is totally devoid of any basis, because emptiness can only be understood in relation to individual objects or individual phenomenon. And for example, when we speak of the emptiness of form, we are talking about an ultimate reality of that form, which is the fact that it is devoid of intrinsic existence. And that emptiness of intrinsic existence of the form is the emptiness of that form. It is the ultimate nature of that form. So apart from the emptiness of multiple things and events, we cannot posit some kind of a great emptiness which sort of serves as a something like a Brahman. So that is a wrong notion.
So today in this time, Kasur, okay, Chechen Gana, Tishin in the Garu Yare, Chechen the Gujiba, and Chuni would Gujiba the Marite, in it, then Chechen Gana, Chuni Gong Garu Yare. So today in this time, Nazanga, Lamlia, Hoku Gong Goyade, so so the Kasur, okay, Chechen Sandy Salon, Jonghensi, Tengne, Gongo Dua. This is the Jari. Chazam. 타이베 추정 원도 집 신이 과유서다 되게 개발도 안 되지.
Since emptiness can only be understood in relation to individual things and events and in terms of understanding their ultimate truths or ultimate reality, so one implication of this is that, for example, if an individual thing comes to an end or ceases to exist, that emptiness of that thing will also cease to exist. Although that emptiness is not a product of cause and conditions, but because the basis upon which the emptiness is understood is no longer there, the emptiness of that thing will also be no longer there. Because of this, in the Vajrayana practice, it is emphasized that when you do a deity yoga meditation, and particularly when you do a meditation on emptiness within the context of deity yoga practice in Vajrayana, it is important to choose a basis, a focus of your meditation, which is a quality of a mind that will retain its continuum and throughout one's lives until the stage of enlightenment. Therefore, one speaks of emptiness of a pure phenomena. And it is also one of the significance of why meditation on emptiness, in meditation on emptiness, the emphasis is placed on taking, choosing mind as the focus of one's meditation. Because in terms of continuum, the mind will also go to the stage of enlightenment. So this is also the case in, for example, in the practices of Mahamudra, the great seal, and Dzogchen, the great perfection practices, where the main focus of meditation and emptiness is one's mind.
Oh yeah.